Hey, my name is Jack, and this is the first video of a short series in which I will explain how L systems work in animation nodes. Basically, L systems provide a way to generate geometry based on text, and in this first video, I want to show you how that conversion exactly happens. In the upcoming videos, I will explain a more efficient way to create more complex text inputs so that we can create more complex L systems or better looking geometry. L systems uses a technique that is often called turtle programming. So basically imagine we have a little turtle here in the center or at the origin, and we can tell it, for example, to move upwards and draw a line and then go upwards again and turn right and move forward again and so on. So basically we give it commands how it should move. L systems uses many different commands, but at first I want to show you the most basic ones. So I created an L system node here and a mesh object output node, and I deactivated most of its sockets because in this video we will only need the axiom here, which basically is the text that is converted into geometry. So the most important symbol is an uppercase F, which means forward. So you can see we start here in the middle and we tell the turtle to move forward, so it points upwards by default, to move forward one direction and draw a line. And we can write F multiple times and the turtle moves forward even more. Another important letter is the lowercase f, which tells the turtle to move forward but don't draw a line. So you can see now we move one step up, then another step but without drawing a line, and then we draw a line again. So everything becomes a bit more interesting when we start with a rotation. So let's say we move up two times, then we rotate plus as a rotation to the right from that direction. So, right, and now we can do plus again, and turning left is a negative sign, and we can move like, we can move like that and basically draw everything we want. Let me just give us some more room here. Now another very important aspect of L systems are branches. So let's say we move up two times again, and now we want that we want to duplicate that turtle and let it move in a this direction while the original turtle still moves upwards, so that we get a branch. And that is fairly easy to do as well by just starting with a square bracket. A square bracket basically makes a copy of the current turtle, and now we inside the pair of brackets we control another turtle. So let me just show you. So basically that means we move up two times, then we copy the common turtle, so we have two turtles. Then we take the second one, rotate it to the right by 90 degrees, move it forward, then the square, closing square bracket means, okay, we stop controlling this turtle and go back to the first one, and then we, so that one is unchanged, and we move it up again. And we can make as many branches as we want. Also, we can nest branches if we want to. And you can see with that we can already create some interesting geometry. And if you go into edit mode, you can also see that these points are connected. So basically, to render this out later, you will need some other modifier so that creates geometry for these edges, because the S system node itself only creates edges. But there are a couple of ways to create real geometry from this, and I will show them in a later video. I prepared a little reference here so that you can see the different symbols that are available for you at the moment. Maybe there will be more in the future, but let's look at some of those here. So we have already seen the uppercase and lowercase F, rotate left and rotate right. But there are also other rotations, like for every axis. So we can, for example, move up one step, move right, move left, move in that direction and in that direction, and so on. So basically, you can see we can create many branches, and these different symbols correspond to different rotations. You can also use a random rotation, which is pretty much completely random at the moment. Let me just enable the seed. So you can see when I change the seed, it creates a different random rotation. Also, if you want to change the step size, so currently every F moves the turtle by one step, and the rotation is always 90 degrees except the random rotation. But that can be modified as well in two ways. The most important way is the step size input of this node. This determines the default step size. So when I change this to 1/2, you can see that every point is only 1/2 away from the other. But this is not the only way, because sometimes you might want that one step is larger than the other. So the A system implementation I wrote supports parameters for certain commands. That means that we have here an F that uses the default step size, and we can tell another F to go three steps instead of just one. Something similar is true for rotations. So when I rotate, this is 90 degrees by default. Also tell it to just rotate by 30 degrees. And there's also a default angle here, which can be modified. Right, that's it for the first video. See you in the next one.